Congratulations, Roxanne. This was an amazing film.
Thank you. It's so good to see you again.
See you. And I have to say that ever since we've been locked down, I've been watching a lot of, you know, kiddie movies and stuff like that. So I have a daughter. And I thought, thank goodness, finally, a really sexy, steamy thriller for some adult time. So,
oh my gosh, right?
Yeah.
It's tough. And then, you know, I got three kids too, so I feel you need to switch it up a little.
So how does it feel that after all this time with the, you know, trying to release it and now it's finally here, how does it feel that the movie's finally going to have an audience, be in a theater, and it's going to be released?
Man, I have to say, I mean, I was a little nervous at first, but I mean, we are so excited. We've been waiting for this movie to come out since June. You know what I mean? And so obviously a summer blockbuster, we're like, oh my God, we can't believe we even had that. And then of course COVID hit. So we're like, okay, great. You don't even know what's going to go on. But I think Lionsgate did an incredible job. They made an amazing decision to put this movie out this year during the holidays, right at the perfect time where everybody needs some escapism. Everybody needs a break from all this chaos and uncertainty. And I feel like Fatale will take you away for that hour and a half, like you said, and make you go on that ride and scream at the screen, be mad, have compassion, have no compassion, like just go all over the place and leave you like at the end, just like, wait, what just happened?
Well, that it's exactly right, because I thought I had it down. I thought I knew exactly what was going to happen, but I was on this cat and mouse chase with all of you, and I had it wrong up until the very end. I had no idea what was going to happen till the end. So Good job. Great job.
Yeah, right?
You were talking about the actors. Obviously, you have a two-time Academy Award winning actress in this film. And I mean, tell the truth. Does she go around acting like a two-time Academy Award winning actress, or is she really down to earth in this, you know, behind the scenes?
I mean, Hilary is, she's super down to earth. I mean, she's so incredible to work with. She's such a team player, and she's brilliant. Like, it's amazing to watch her work. You know, I've said to a couple of people, like, I felt honored just to be on set with her. You know what I mean? And it's amazing to watch her go into these modes to get that perfect scene, and how hard she works countless hours to make sure she gets it right, and making sure that we're happy that what she's delivering is what we need. You know, so she was incredible to work with.
Yeah. And I mean, let's get past, I don't even know if we can get past those blue eyes with Michael, but once we do get past his blue eyes, he was really great in this film.
Man, listen, you can't go wrong with Michael Ealy outside of his, you know, looks, right? That everybody physically attracts to immediately. I mean, he's an amazing actor, you know what I mean? And he will give you those layers that you need for this kind of movie. Like, Michael is, even though, you know, and not to say too much, I mean, she's manipulating him this whole movie. He's still like the look in his eyes. I'm like, what has he got up his sleeve? Because he's crazy too. You know what I mean? He's crazy too, but he's so smart, and he's so humble, and he's so committed to the roles as well. He works really, really hard. And I think this role was really like, it was a challenge for him too, to stand next to Hilary Swank, right? And go toe to toe, and he nailed it. You know what I mean? Their energy was electric, and he didn't miss a beat. And I'm so proud of him. I'm so proud of him.
I'm sure you must be proud of Dion as well. I mean, as he's proud of you, but yes. I mean, it has been a challenging year. So how proud are you of Dion and how he's taken this movie and made it possible?
I mean, listen, I'm his biggest fan. You know what I mean? I've known him for a very long time, and just to watch him over the years become the filmmaker that he's become is, it's shocking. You know what I mean? And it's something I see people work their whole life for. And I feel like this is where he's supposed to be. He's got it. I mean, he's an actor's director. He immediately connects. He gives them the floor. He welcomes the feedback. And I think when you have those kinds of relationships and that kind of energy with the talent, you can get anything from them. You can get people who don't do stunts to do stunts. You know what I mean? Like, you can get everything from them. And it's really important because it's tough. The director's the leader on set. You know what I mean? And so sometimes different people aren't always as open and willing to take, you know, feedback. And it's really incredible to see him from his first movie to, you know, 11th movie, and how much he's grown and shaped into one of, I think, the best filmmakers out there. And he has such a long journey ahead of him.
I can't wait to see what 2021 brings for you both. Thank you so much, Natasha.
Great to see you.
Happy holidays.
All right, bye.
Bye, congrats.
Thank you.